in my village, yeah. I start reminiscing, yeah. This time around, fuck, I wanted to be good for you. Waiting on a sign, guess it's time for a different prayer. Lord, please favor for me. Do this one favor for me. Hey my faves, welcome back to a brand new video. If you are new here, my name is Songa Sikunya, and if you are returning, Sabi, welcome back my love, welcome back Stando-san. Guys, and bona ndiyanithanda ne, ndiniswenkele, I look good, I'm dressed in what, and guess what we're here about. But before we get into that, guys, please, don't forget to share this video with your loved ones. Don't forget to share the page with your loved ones. Thank you so much for 400 subscribers, and I'm hoping we continue to grow. Please, please, please share this video with your loved ones. Don't gatekeep the content. Don't gatekeep the love. And then what else did I want to say again? Sorry guys, I got distracted. Has been eating this whole like corner. Look like Indosoni Peggy, you know. You know, don't get on. But yeah, don't forget to share, and also don't forget to like. Give this video a huge thumbs up if you like this type of content, if you enjoy this type of content. And don't forget to engage with me in the comment section below. Tell me what else you'd like to hear, what you've missed, whatever it is you want to talk about. Engage with me in the comment section below, and I promise you, I will get back to you. Anyway, today we are here, as you guys can see, I even have a notebook. We are here with regards to my last trip, Mozambique. So I am answering, I'm not answering questions. I'm just giving you guys more of a detailed view. So it's like a sit down. Well, it's not like a sit down. It is a sit down. Should have had like a young drink. Maybe I should make something to drink quickly. But what do I want? Okay guys, I come back. A girl's gotta do what a girl's gotta do. So cheers, I have poured myself a glass of sweet white. It's been a minute since I've had something like this. And it's during the day. So, is it acceptable? But yeah, I even have my laptop out here because difuna ukunika information exact, guys. But yeah, as you guys know, I recently went on a trip to Mozambique. And yeah, I just came on here to let you guys know how much we spent, what we did, what you should budget if you are considering going there. What the vibes are like, you don't get it too long though. But yeah, okay. Oh, okay. So let's get into it. So first things first, I went there. Me and Uneza, Lindyambeno Uneza, we made it out of the group chat. When I tell you guys, the group chat was full, but we are the only ones who made it out. I'm not even lying. But yeah, we went on the trip together, so we used a travel agency called Divine Travel Experience. So you can find them on Instagram. I'm also going to put it in the screen what you should search on Instagram, and I'm also going to link their page in the description box, right? So we don't trust the travel agencies, guys. It's very tough unless they have a physical office, right? So how did I go about this was I got the plug from my sister's colleague, so the lady that owns Divine Travel Experience, Ukensani, is her friend, so that's how we were able to trust the agency. But okay, they must be legit, she knows them, she's used them I think for a couple of trips within South Africa, so we trusted them. And she was very communicative, is that even a word? But she was very responsive, that's the word I'm looking for. She was very responsive from the first time I texted her, because I went to Instagram, checked out the Instagram page, and then from there took the WhatsApp number, sent her a message on WhatsApp, and she was very responsive, shame, which was something that I truly appreciated because I'm an overthinker and an overplanner. So I need to know everything is to the T. So Kensan was very responsive. Big ups to her. Yeah, so that's who we used, and overall, it was a great experience. So the Moz trip that we went on is a group trip, but she does curate individual trips. If you're looking for an individual trip, she does curate like trips for couples, trips for families, whatever it is that you're looking for. Guys, I even wrote notes. That's how serious I am. Nalinda bale yokunika information. But yeah, how much did we pay? I know that's the first thing that a lot of you are wondering. We paid 7,200 rand for the trip, or to the agency, basically 7,200 rand. But I think for 2025, because I think her 2024 trips are fully booked, but you can go check for yourself, because I do know she has one coming up in December. Yeah, I think it's in December. But yeah, you can always go ahead and check on the Instagram page yourself. But for 2025, I think it's increased to just under 8,000 rand. So you're looking at about 8,000 rand for the travel agency alone, right? And that covers basically accommodation. And we stayed in the first, so it's 3 nights and 4 days. And they basically curate the activities that you're going to be doing as well. Like, you're not stressing about, oh, what am I going to do? I've never been to this place. They curate all of that for you. Then you just pick and choose what you do want to do. So it's not compulsory that you do everything, because obviously it's additional costs. But what does the 7,200 rand that we paid cover? It covered accommodation, and it also covered breakfast every day. So lunch and dinner is not included, so that would be out of pocket, right? So accommodation, the first accommodation that we stayed at for the first 2 nights is, oh, and transport to get there. How can I forget that? And transport to get there, which, yeah, if you're looking at flying, for example, because we did consider coming back with the flight, I think it was about 2.4 per flight. So it's definitely a bargain, like 2.4 one way plus minus. So obviously 2025 the rates is probably going to be even higher, but it is road transport. So one, you don't get to drive. Two, you're driving with people who know the place. Her drivers are very like accustomed with the place. They're very familiar with the people. Like from the time we stopped after the boarding gate, well, from the time we get stopped at the boarding gate, because obviously we're South Africans, they know we're here to party. So are they all too excited about that? Or they know we're here to jamula, basically, because some people don't even party. They are going to have some sort of attitude towards you. So going there with people that are familiar with the place makes it so much easier, because they'll be communicating with them in their languages. I think if you are Tonga or Venda, you know, which is very close to Shanghai, it could be to your advantage. But if you're like me, and guys, I've been in Joburg for 9 years, but I still can't speak other languages. If you're like me, you're definitely going to need someone also kwazi ukuthetha their language, abantu base Mozambique, because a lot of them are either speak Shanghai. I don't know if Shanghai is a real language, guys. Like, is it actually called Shanghai? And as, or baza ukuthetha is Portuguese. So sometimes they really don't understand English. So having a travel agency, listen to me, Kenzani, you must pay me. I'm selling it divine. But yeah, it's very refreshing, because in terms of communication, it's easier, right? So yeah, we get to the border, and then once we cross the border, from that point, you see how good they can communicate with the people. Because if you want, you can get a SIM card just as you cross the border. If you want to be available throughout, but both the accommodations that we used and the places that we visited had Wi-Fi. So if you don't want to be available 24/7, which is what I did, I was just partially available because I wanted to live in the moment, you can just use the Wi-Fi, but you can always get a SIM card. I'm not sure how much people paid because it went with negotiation skills as well. So if your driver could negotiate for you, then sharp, you know? So we had drivers, very nice people. I'd definitely travel with them again. They are very vibey, nabo. So yeah, on to accommodation. So the first two nights we stayed in Ebileni. I think that's how you pronounce it. I know the Xhosa like Ebileni. But yeah, where we stayed in San Martino Beach Club. So if you haven't watched my vlog, as is it was previous, now is your chance to go back, because guys, you will see as you walk in there, like I was in so much awe. But yeah, you'll have to watch the vlog to see. So we stayed in villas, which were three bedroom, like the one that we stayed in was a three bedroom. There were some that had more rooms. There were some that had less rooms. So it's a three bedroom villa. It's shared by six people. So it is a group trip, as I've already told you guys, and it was quite a big group for us. And surprisingly, everyone got along. Guys, I was so worried when I found out how many people were going to be on that trip. Close to 30. I was like, like, I'm a very social person, but the social anxiety and part, like, it can. But I never had a reason to let my social anxiety take over. Anyway, you share the villa with six people. There's six of you guys in the three-bedroom villa. So per bedroom takes two people. So obviously, Nano Meza, we shared a bedroom, and then we shared with four other strangers, which we became very friendly with and familiar, and you know, it was a good time, man. And then our villa had two bathrooms. The one bathroom was an ensuite, so that like a couple took it, and then the other bathroom we were sharing amongst four of us, and it's literally by the beachfront. As you walk out of your sliding door, the beach is there. Oh guys, it's beautiful. It has its nice veranda patio thing. Like, it's beautiful. Like, you literally just have to go and watch that vlog and research for yourself to see it in detail. But yeah, then in Maputo, we stayed at Stay Easy Maputo, which is a 4-star hotel. It's under Southern Sun. Once again, watch the Maputo vlog, then you'll see what the hotel looks like. But it looks like the standard Southern Sun hotels. So if you've slept in a Southern Sun hotel, expect the same type of, like the same level of, what is the word that I'm looking for? You guys know what I mean, guys. And that's not this strong again. Don't mind more wrong. Yeah, but expect the same level of professionalism, the same level of style. Like, it's a typical, it's a typical 4-star Southern Sun hotel. And on top of that, Tina, we got a fifth floor room, which is they have five floors. So nje, our view was stunning. Guys, I would wake up in the morning and I'd be like, I can't believe this is my life. Okay, let me not get emotional. But guys, I was emotional throughout that trip. It was my first ever international trip, and this is something that I've always wanted to do. So seeing it, seeing it come to fruition and to life like that was like, girl, this is happening. Like, guys, for me, these things are amazing because they were on my vision board, and seeing my vision board come to life is like, yeah. Anyway, let's move on. So in terms of cost, what would I say you need to budget outside of the money that you pay the travel agency? I would say you must budget at least 5,000 rand if you're trying to be like not stressed at all. That's what we did. We budgeted 5,000 rand each. So that includes the money that you're going to spend on the way there, the money you're going to spend on the way back, the money you're going to spend on activities, everything. In my opinion, Mozambique is very low cost. It's the perfect place to travel to for your first travel experience, right? Hey guys, there's the bands, and so that's why I keep looking at my laptop. Okay, so yeah, as I was saying, what was I saying there? Oh yeah, just have that much. Obviously, this is also excluding a maintenance. So maintenance differs from person to person. Are you the type of person who wants new outfits for your entire trip? Shein is your girly. All of my outfits were bought from Shein, guys. Like everything. Okay, maybe one. But it wasn't like something that I wore like that. I think just the orange dress I bought from Eclairs, but everything else was from Shein, except for the shoes, obviously. Excuse me. And the bags and sunglasses. But yeah, maintenance is dependent on how much you spend on maintenance. So especially us females, you know, we want to get our hair done, our nails done, our lashes done, blah, 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 zonke zonto. So that is dependent on you. And then I would say budget 5K. Some people do budget 3K and it is sufficient. We did come back with quite a bit of change. I'm sure we came back with like close to 1.5 change because we went for lunch on the day that we came back. Yeah. But anyway, why am I saying that? Now I'm gonna go into more detail. I'll try not to do the itinerary word by word because obviously it changes. And number two, you don't need to do all of these activities, right? So now I had done an itinerary slash budget for us, which I have open on my emails here. Yeah, so the first thing is activities. So in Bileni, we did the sunset cruise, which cost plus minus 350 per person, which we did on day one, right? And so you have to pay this 350 to the travel agency beforehand so that they can book it in advance because it is a group activity. So if you don't want to do it, you're not forced to do it. If you do want to do it, you can do it. And then another thing that will come up in day two that you need to pay for in advance is the sunset. No, not the sunset cruise, the speedboat. But yeah, I'll let you guys know how much that was when we get there. And then another thing that we did, we had lunch on arrival because obviously we had been on the road throughout the night and the morning. So we had had breakfast on the road, which wasn't costly even. Everything Tinake we had over budgeted for. So that's what helped us. So I would say over budget rather than under budget. So that is what we are in change. If we are in change rather than we short as what's this thing? The currency, yes, in Mozambique, which is meticals, is weaker than the South African rand. So that does work in your advantage as well. So yeah, we had lunch on arrival and we had a pizza, which was pretty affordable. It was like a standard pizza price, even in South Africa. And then we had dinner later, which turned into groove. Once again, if you're not the groovy type, you're gonna save on this because you can either go to the sandbar restaurant, which is on site, and order something there, then have an early night, take in everything, or you can go with everyone to where we went to go get dinner, where we ended up actually grooving because the food took so long to get there, guys. So this is something that you need to understand, especially Epilene. A lot of the places take a long time to make the food. So if you can, maybe at the last stop, because I think there was like abo okay, ababa basikaraj kapagati or Woolworths. Buy something oyaziba, you'll have it for the whole weekend. Something that you can quickly warm up in the microwave or just stock up on snacks. You can even maybe get muesli and yogurt at that last stop because it is very hot, but there were coolers in the cars, so you could put maybe your yogurt there. So that was ba in between while you're waiting. Because you will wait, and if you are someone who loves your stomach, you will get cranky, then you can have that. So that's one tip that I would say. So day two, what activities did we do? So one, we had planned to either do canoeing, paddle boat or windsurfing, which all of them are under 150 rand for about 15 minutes per person, We had planned to do that, but one, we didn't have time, two, we were so tired, so we ended up not doing it. So that's about 500 meticals. Yeah, if you want it in, what's this thing, in meticals, because we did withdraw cash to do a lot of things there. Because guys, let me tell you something, the bank charges, and there's only bank charges, Zangena, when I was back in South Africa. Managing notification, international charges. So if you can, just withdraw as much as possible. I would suggest you withdraw 10,000 meticals. I know it sounds like a lot of money, guys, but it's not, because that's how much we withdraw. That's how much we withdrew amongst the two of us. So 5,000 meticals. And we finished it. And we still needed to swipe with Nindao. And as figure a Maputo, Sapilisa withdraw, I think we withdrew another 5,000 meticals. So in total, we withdrew about 15,000 meticals. It sounds like a lot of money. But guys, let me tell you, it's not even 5,000 rands, is it? Yeah, you can do the conversion divided by 3.5, but it's not as much as it seems. So I would suggest you withdraw as much as you possibly can so that you avoid e-bank charges by swiping everywhere. A lot of places do accept the Visa. But if usebenzisa Capitec, guys, most places don't accept Capitec. Time Bank, some places don't accept. So I would suggest you go with the bigger banks that do international purchases. And also remember to activate your international purchases before going there. Okay, I keep going off, but again, as I understand this, you know, they come as I go. Then the other activity that we did was jet skiing. I was like, no matter what, I will do a jet ski. And you know, that wasted time is that thing of wanting to take content and whatnot, because Neza and I spent a lot of time walking, looking for the perfect spot to get the perfect pictures. But I really enjoyed the walking, guys. But we were so sunburned by the end of the trip because we were walking everywhere. But yeah, we did a jet ski, which is about 3,500 meticals, which is equated to 1,000 rand for 30 minutes. But the nice thing about them, e jet skis, is that you can split the cost. So if they say 3,500 meticals for 30 minutes, we split them three ways and we each did 10 minutes, because we're not amazing. Like, it was my first time doing jet skiing. We're not amazing, so it doesn't make sense for you to be on the water for 30 minutes. Excuse me. Also, eventually the thrill is going to end, guys, if you're there for 30 minutes. Maybe if you want a longer time, you guys could split it two ways. 15 minutes, but we each did 10 minutes, and it was exciting. It was amazing. Yeah, which is about 340 per person. Well, less than 340 per person. And then, as I said earlier on, we also took a speed boat to Ngungwa Lodge, which we did on day two, right? So Ngungwa Lodge is just like a chill spot. Very cute as well. Some people got that side and they did quad biking. I'm not sure exactly how much that is, but I do know that it is cheaper than the jet skiing. And you can also split it. So you can just do more research with regards to that. I'll see if I can put it on the screen. So for the speedboat, we needed to pay 165 rand per person beforehand to a Divine Travel Experience, right? So that they can book the speedboat in advance, because the speedboat needed to take us from San Martino to Ngungwa, right? And another tip. I'm going to keep giving tips in between, guys. I hope this video is not going to be too long. Another tip when it comes to you going to Ngungwa, please, if you don't eat seafood, rather eat at the sandbar lounge, because they only had seafood. And I think it's because that's what's easier for them to get, because they are more Italian, like island vibes, right? So they only had seafood. Like, they have chicken, pizza and stuff on the menu, but they did not have. But it's a nice place, and they played lots of South African music, and it's nice. Like, it's a good place to experience. I would definitely suggest you still go, even if you don't eat seafood, but maybe eat prior. Yeah, and then later on that day, we went to Groove. Once again, if you're not big on Groove, you are going to say on this. So the last day that we were in Bileni was not that costly. Was not that costly in terms of money, because we woke up, had breakfast, which is included already in the money that you paid to the travel agency. And it's nice because it's buffet, guys. You get juice, you get doni. But if you are going to be buying alcoholic drinks, you are going to pay on the side, obviously. But you get juice included, coffees included, teas included, like the general stuff. And general juices, like they have specified juices for breakfast, like fruit juices. So if you want a Coke when with your breakfast, you're going to have to pay. If you want a passion fruit and lemonade, you're going to have to pay. Kanjalo. But if you're just having a fruit juice, if you're having water, if you're having coffee, it's all inclusive. Right? So I would say for the last day, you should budget at least 500 rand for... I didn't convert it to meticals, but we already had the meticals. I think it was 2,000 plus minus 2,000 meticals for e-souvenirs. And I would suggest you have cash once again for the market, because it makes it easier for you to negotiate. Because guys, and don't take this negotiating thing as a bad thing, because it's not that you're negotiating because you're trying to rob them, but you're negotiating because as soon as they see when you are a tourist, they will charge you higher than the price. Let me tell you that now. So you must now, I'm going to try and negotiate to the price that they would sell to locals for. Because now I got locals, I'll spend money up at the end of the day. You're not trying to overspend. You have a budget. You came here with a budget, you know? So that's what we did. Passed by Bileni Market, got some souvenirs, got some really cute t-shirts. Ah, I wish I had it right now, but it is what it is. Oh, but you guys saw Uneza. So if you haven't watched the vlog, go back to the vlog. So we bought those t-shirts and these cute shorts as well for Inam. And all of that, I think it was 3 t-shirts and 1 shorts, all of that under 500 rand. 4 items under 500 rand, guys. That is a bargain. And then when we got to Emaputo, we went to South Beach, right? Which is a bit costly. But if you've been to Cape Town, guys, the prices are similar. I'm not even gonna lie. Rockefeller. If you've been to a Rockefeller hotel, the prices at Rockefeller are actually higher than South Beach, as an example, just to give you an example. Also, if you're going to go to Camps Bay, the prices in Camps Bay are higher. When I say prices, I say Cape Town are similar to this. I'm talking about prices go waterfront, like those restaurants by waterfront and whatnot. But if you're going to go to the bougier places like Camps Bay, like go to Indawizitanda and Jengo Rockefeller, you're going to be paying more. So personally, Neza and I didn't find it to be too bad because we have gone on holiday with our sisters in Cape Town. So it was expected. It wasn't anything that was too bad. I think the thing that would probably cost you a bit more is cocktails, which you'll be getting cocktails for like 180 something, 170 something. Nothing under 160, if I'm being honest with the cocktails. But once again, if you've been to Cape Town, there's places that have cocktails that are even more expensive than that in Cape Town. But get us call up, huh? And then in terms of day 4, what you're looking at spending is, we went to Maputo Market, which doesn't have much, but you can get more souvenirs there. We did get amalapo for our mothers, abazawathungisa, and make them into dresses. There were people babethunga phazo. If you want to come home with like a traditional dress, you can get it done there. But obviously, because they weren't there and we were going to get the measurements wrong, we just bought the material, which is way cheaper than the materials that you'll get in South Africa to make dresses, right? And I'm talking about amalapa qinileyo, guys, like proper traditional material. That's what we got. And then we just got like some beach bags and stuff. I feel like I should have these here with me. But yeah, a condo. You guys will see the bag in one of my, it's just a straw bag. Yeah, it's just a straw bag, which I think, if I'm not mistaken, each one was 500 meticals, which is around 150, somewhere there, rands. You can use it for picnics, you can use it for the beach. So I'm mostly going to use it for picnics because obviously I'm in Joburg, no beach. But yeah, then the last stop that we went to was the fish market, where we spent about 5,000 meticals, right? For everything that we bought. We had a seafood platter, which came with fish, prawns, calamari, salad, rice, and fries. And then we also on the side got lobster because it didn't come as part of the seafood platter. We had lobster, which also came with its own size, which would be salad, rice, and fries, right? And this was 5,000 meticals, which is equal to 1,000 rand, 400 rand, plus minus, just a bit less, but I rounded up. But the portions are huge. So we shared this platter by four. So you take this 1,400 rand and you divide it by four, which is about 350 per person. Which, if you're buying a seafood boil in South Africa, are you not going to spend about the same amount? Most probably. If not more, actually. So yeah, that is about it for like what we spent, what we did. But yeah, if there's anything I left out, it's probably in the vlog, guys. If there's anything I forgot, but in terms of like costs, I really don't think I forgot anything. Let me see, because this was more detailed. And hopefully we will be doing these international trips once a year. Like, I'm looking forward to doing them at least once a year. Like, God willing, and with God's provision, I truly believe that it should happen at least once a year. But we'll still be doing like other trips throughout the year. Obviously, I'm always catching flights, but not feelings. Joking. But yeah, guys, another tip that I would give to you guys is please pack your meds. Like, I had meds for everything, guys, because charcoal tablets, they also help with digestive system. I'll just name the biggest ones, but now you'll know what works for you. You need to pack charcoal tablets. They help with digestive systems, they help with hangovers. Whatever you need them for, they will help you. Because obviously you're going to be eating different types of foods that you're not used to. So you might not be able to go to the bathroom and do number two. So they are going to help you pass some stool. Sorry guys to be so explicit, but we all know how uncomfortable it gets when you're bloated, but nothing is coming out. So charcoal tablets, definitely, definitely recommend. It was the first time I took them as well. So these are just travel essentials that I would say you must have. Panado tablets, because it's very hot, you're probably going to be getting headaches. If you are a drinker, you're probably going to be getting headaches in the morning as well. So Panado or Grandpa will do you good. I had Grandpa. Allergics, guys. Allergics is very important. Your girl had a rash all over her shoulders. Guys, I wanted to cry. It was so bad. But yeah, make sure you have the allergics. If you can, get a cream as well. Allergies. So I would say get the allergics and also get tablets for skin allergies. Because chances are, if you're someone like me, uzodibana neplant, uzodibana na something, ongayaziyo, and your skin is going to react. So I reacted and I wasn't sure what it was related to. But when I got back to SA, I got tablets for skin allergies because I only had the allergics. So it was just alleviating the itching, but it wasn't helping with the actual rash, right? So I would say get net tablets, skin rashes, just to be on the safe side. So the allergics, and your skin rashes treatment. And then some cream as well for if you get a rash. Because one, you could also get heat rash as well. So that's going to be helpful with heat rash. Or you could get an actual allergy, which is what I got. And then what other tablets? Oh, carry things for flu. At some point, my tonsils were acting up because we had been partying too much. And luckily, the day we came back from South Beach, I just got to the room, I took izinto zam zomqala, I woke up, I was almost as good as new. My voice was still gone, but at least my tonsils were not as painful. All right? And then what else? Yeah, I think that's about it in terms of medication. And then depending where you are traveling, so if you are going to Mozambique, you're going to have to take anti-malarial tablets beforehand, during, and after the trip. But if you are using a travel agency, once again, they tell you about this, which is amazing because I never would have known. But yeah, we used Imozitec. A lot of us used Imozitec because that's what most pharmacies have in South Africa. Be aware that most medical aids, yo. Okay. Be aware that most medical aids don't pay for Imozitec. It is quite costly. It's about 450. So you need to factor this into your cost as well. My medical aid did. And call me guys, dear choker. I'm just saying, but luckily I'm medical aid, but a little under the stress, but yeah. So it depends what kind of medical aid you have as well. But most, like 90% of medical aids don't pay for Imozitec. And then don't forget your sunscreen. Very, very important that you bring sunscreen along with you. But yeah, I hope there's no tips that I forgot. If there's any other questions that you guys have for me, you can drop them in the comment section below. And I'll be sure to make time to answer them somewhere, somehow in my next vlog. But I really hope I've answered everything and I've given you guys enough tips. And I really hope that I will be seeing you guys going to Mozambique and using Divine Travel Experience. And yeah, but just go look them up. They've got lots of trips. They've got trips that are overseas as well. They've got trips in SA as well. They've got things like the Snowcation in Lesotho. They've got Cape Town. Whatever it is, even if you want to start small and you want to do Mpumalanga, which will be way less costly. But once again, in Mpumalanga, you need to keep in mind that it requires, excuse me, umuntu who's willing to do activities like bungee jumping, no, which I'm not. But yeah, just look them up. And I really, really hope that this video was informative and that you guys enjoyed listening to me blab on and on and on. And I really hope it wasn't too long and you guys made it this far. And if you did, please don't forget to share once again. Don't forget to comment. Don't forget to like. And don't forget to subscribe if you are not subscribed yet. Until next time, I love you. I wish